This video is sponsored by DFRobot. Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. If you're here from the previous video, glad to see you back. I assume that you've just finished project number 12. If so, let's move on to project number 13, or DIY fan. This time we would make our own mini fan using a few components and a new line of code called the bounce. Let's go! Here are the things that we're going to need for this project. Our DF Arduino board, prototyping shield, male-to-male jumper cables, 130 motor, a relay, mini push button, 220 ohm resistors, fan blade, and of course, a 5mm LED. Moving on to the wiring phase, first up, let's get our DF Arduino board. Mount the prototyping shield on top of it. Now, let's take a look at the relay. It seems like it can handle loads of up to 1 amp 24 volts DC or 1 amp 120 volts AC. These two are legs 3 and 4 according to the wiring diagram on the PDF, by the way. Let's just put this one right here. Place the mini push button right here. Attach this resistor right about here. This is going to be our mini push button's pull-down resistor. Attach the red LED right here, in line with the relay's pin number 6. Keep in mind that the LED's cathode is on the right side. The reason why we're doing that is because the relay's pin number 6 should be connected to the motor's 5V pin. Attach another 220 ohm resistor right here and connect it to the LED's cathode. Next up, let's get our 130 motor and attach the fan blade to it. Connect the motor's black wire to ground and the red one to the relay's pin number 6. There we go. Hold up, let me just transfer the resistor's leg to this part because it's going to be in line with the push button and that would make erratic results. Alright, let's start by connecting these things to ground. First is the LED's cathode via the resistor that is connected to it. Second is the resistor that is connected to the push button, followed by the relay's pin number 2 to ground as well. Connect the relay's pin number 4 to 5 volts, followed by the mini push button. Connect the mini push button to DF Arduino's digital pin number 2. And lastly, connect pin number 1 of the relay to DF Arduino's digital pin number 3. What should happen is when the push button has been pushed, the red LED would light up and the fan blade would start spinning. Alright, now let's connect our board to the computer. Here's the sample code that DFRobot has provided. Make sure that the MCU is being detected and we're on the correct port. Click on verify, then upload the code. Okay, as you have noticed, right after uploading the code, both the LED and motor is already turned on. Let's try turning it off by pushing the push button. There we go. Let's turn it on again. Let's turn it off again. Turn it on, turn it off, turn it on again, turn it off, turn it on, and turn it off. Well, that's it for the code demo. Now this is how the code works. Apart from the familiar looking codes that have been declared, here we have a new one called the bounce.
Push buttons often generate spurious open-close transitions when pressed, due to mechanical and physical issues. These transitions may be read as multiple presses in a very short time, fooling the program.
The addition of the bounce would make the program check, check, check twice in a short period of time.
You have programmed your brain wrong.
Sorry. The addition of the bounce would make the program check twice in a short period of time to make sure that the push button is definitely pressed. Think of it like your phone's accidental touch protection to eliminate pocket dialing. So first, we declare the pin numbers for the push button and relay. We declare the relay state to high as the current state of the output pin. We declare button state to record the current reading from the input pin. We set the last button state to low as the previous reading from the input pin. We set the last debounce time to 0 or the last time the output pin was toggled. Then we set the debounce delay to 50 or the debounce time. We used long variables here because the time, measured in milliseconds, will quickly become a bigger number than can be stored in an int data type. Moving on to the void setup, we set the button pin to input and the relay pin to output using pin mode. Then, set the relay pin to be high using the relay state variable that we have declared earlier using digital write to set the initial relay state. Onto the void loop, here we have a variable called reading, which is set to represent digital read button pin or DF Arduino's digital pin number 2 to read the state of the switch into a local variable. followed by an if statement to check if you just pressed the button or switch. This block of code means if reading or digital read button pin is not equal to the last button state or low, or if the state went from low to high due to pressing or noise, last the bounce time which was initially set to 0 would be changed to the value of millis or the number of milliseconds passed since the program started to reset the debouncing timer. This line of code means that whatever the reading is at, it's been there longer or the value of it is higher than the debounce delay, so take it as actual current state. If we try to compute it, if millis, which is let's just say 5 seconds or 5000 milliseconds has passed since the program has started, minus last debounce time which was initially set to 0 is greater than 50 milliseconds, well, it's clearly higher than 50 milliseconds, so we're going to use it as the actual current state. If reading is not equal to button state, or if the button state has changed, button state equals reading. If button state is equal to high, relay state equals not relay state means to only toggle the relay if the new button state is equal to high. Digital write relay pin relay state to set the relay. And lastly, last button state equals reading to save the reading state. Then, next time through the loop, it'll be the last button state. And that's it. I know that it can be quite confusing, so for a more in-depth explanation, please refer to the PDF. Click right here if you feel ready to move on to the next project. See ya!